Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm proud to present this 2008 Opel or Vauxhall Corsa, and this is going to be full in depth tour of the Corsa. We'll start up, show the engine, go on some performance details, show you a bunch of the interesting features inside and out. And so, here's the key, flip key. Let's start the engine, hold it on for a while. Also, this car comes equipped with the aftermarket alarm with remote start. Very convenient feature. Beautiful. Bright yellow exterior. As you can see, back windows are fully tinted. Very wide opening doors. It's almost like 90 degree. Two-tone interior. Very nice. Three-spoke design, multifunctional steering wheel, comes equipped with hydraulic assist power steering, rocking pinion. Beautiful. Fixed steering wheel, manual tilt and telescopic to adjust user's level right here. Right now, so in the headlight, front rear fog light, high beam, as well as the headlights. Front windows are fully automatic in both directions, up and down. Very nice. Right now let's open the hood and take a good look at the exterior of this car. Storage for the driver. Decoded spoiler with the brake light, adhesion antenna, rear defrosting glass, rear wiper, rear parking assist, license plate lights, beautiful 17-inch alloy wheels, tires measuring 215/45, continental tires, rear drum brakes, mat flaps, And I must say, this is my favorite generation of the Corsa. Very elegant and stylish body lines. Turn signal indicators and fenders. Heated windshield wipers, this area. Halogen headlamps, front parking assist, fog light, chrome accent grille, gorgeous, just gorgeous. This car has inline 4, 16 valve, 1.2 liter, natural aspirated engine. It produces 80 horsepower. Maximum speed of 170 km per hour. 0 to 6 time is 15 seconds. Combined fuel consumption for this car is around 6.5 liter per 100 km. The car is front wheel drive. Beautiful, just beautiful body lines. Thank you. And right now, guys, we take a good look at the exterior. Let's take a good look at the interior portion. Padded door panels. High gloss black finish. Storage bottle holder. Your power mirrors. They also heated. Driver's seat has manual adjustment, standard sliding, seat high recline, adjustable seatbelt and headrest. This car has 4 airbag. Clean carpet, by the way. Brightness of the instrument cluster, hide the headlights for the fog light. And right now, guys, let's see what kind of noise this car produces. And this particular has 123,640 kilometers in it. For such a small car, not bad at all. That's the aftermarket parking assist, front and rear. Light and heater controls, and here's your intermittent wipe control. Very easy to read gauges. Your audio controls on the steering wheel, select between different track or select between different station. Select between different saws, your auxiliary, CD and radio. Two-tone plastic, as you can see. Build quality and all the materials are pretty good. You can find hard touch almost everywhere. Your little LCD display, your data, it's a temperature, clock adjustment, your data, audio with 6 speakers for the factory audio sounds pretty good. Your central lock, tone of the airbag, hands, high gloss black finish right here, and chrome, MFM, select between different track or different station, eject, your different settings, volume. Down here you can find easy to use climate control, your temperature, fan speed control, your different modes, rear defrost, air conditioning and recycle. Lighter, or you can use the separator if you don't smoke. 2 cup holders, your auxiliary for the drive, plus and minus for the upshift and for the downshift, neutral, reverse. Quite easy actually to use, but this transmission is just unreliable, that's for sure. Your winter mode, sport mode, I prefer manual or fully automatic. Very light e-brake, small cup holder. I guess the only thing is missing convenient armrest, manual dim rear view mirror, that's for the aftermarket alarm system, sun visor, car holder, vent mirror, no illumination, as you can see already broken. Your map lights. What happened? Alright then. As you can see, Visibility is pretty good, but very small mirrors. And I'm 6'3 myself. This is quite nice. Thigh support is pretty good. And once again, build quality is just nice, very nice. Nothing to complain about. Ergonomically, everything is pretty good put together here. Huge door bin, not extra storage right here. And I guess only thing is missing right now, heated seats. That would be lovely. Right now, let's shut her down and let's move on the back seat. Also very wide opening doors, manual rear windows, back seat is a default, completely flat to increase more cargo space. And I must say, quite easy to get in and out, solid doors. Coat hook, my legroom, and my headroom is pretty good. Central tunnel. Don't expect to find any armrest, just adjustable headrest, and this car, rear seat has ISOFIX system. Nice, quite nice. Very simple and stylish exterior. Trunk is pretty small, but I think that it definitely suits your daily needs. You can remove this cover if you wish. Storage. Air compressor. And down here you can find your full-size spare tire, toolkit and jack. And extra storage. So, in general, not bad. Very convenient handle. Your fuel cap. And I must say, back visibility is pretty poor. Also, you can turn off front passenger airbag. And you can find same manual adjustment for the passenger seat, minus seat height. Huge bar window, this controller. nice size. Welcome party. Here's your manuals, booklets, service. So, Russian specification. And also, guys, I forget to mention Renault Clio and Hyundai i20 and maybe Fiat Punto. But in general, very nicely equipped German car. Gorgeous interior as well as exterior. Well, guys, hope you enjoy my in-depth look at this 2008 Opel Vauxhall Corsa. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. Be sure to catch me next time. There's a plenty more I came from. Thanks for watching and take care, guys.